turned into green, then it was red.
This place is a gold mine.
It's a certainty. I mean, these are people who've been abandoned by their political class. But at least they have what we don't. A sense of identity.
Right, come on, let's get it over with.
An identity encapsulated in four digits.
If we're not back in an hour, call the police.
What shall I say?
Just tell them we're dead.
As I walk round and round the penny arcade, just ring a bell on your big back.
The Battle of the Boyne was fought on the 11th of July, 1690, between two rival claimants of the British and Irish thrones, James II, Catholic, and William of Orange, Protestant. The battle was decisive. The Protestants won. But 400 years later, the uncompromising and victorious loyalists now feel estranged from the modern, secular United Kingdom.
Let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time.
The sectarian songs have been banned, but they still gather and remain loyal to the victory of 1690 and to a simpler, less tolerant time.
It's the greatest sight that I have ever seen. You're red hot. You're red hot dancing. When you skip the hips and you do the salsa, rock for the back, and then you do it again.
But if nothing else, history has shown us very clearly these are people whom it is unwise to provoke.
He's only from round here, are you, lads? You're not going to give us a song?
I can sing, I'll just fucking make something up. You can play the piano.
I can't play the fucking piano.
You know those two chords the fucking F and G march used to play at school? Do that.
Good evening. My mate and I would like to sing a song that we wrote.
No.
Is that it? It was the year of 1690. On the 11th of July, or the 1st in Julian calendar. Wait.
Give me something with a wee bit of rhythm. Here we go. It was on the field of battle. Of hope we were bereft, but by the time that it was over, there were no more Catholics left. We looked up to King William on his chin a royal cleft, and by the time that it was over, there were no more Catholics left. Aye, fucking right. His strategy was strong, his strategy was deft, and by the time that it was over, now victorious, we foiled his papist theft. Yes. When the time was over, there were no more Catholics left. Oh! No more Catholics.
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 No more
Catholics.
No more.
Drive.
690.
What? 690?
1690. Midnight. Start again. So, there's this room service guy, right? And he comes into the room and there is Georgie Best lying on the bed with two Playboy models. Three in a bed, champagne and a wee bit of Charlie, and there's banknotes. But they're lying on the banknotes.
Lying on the money?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know, because he has a lot of money. Or at least he had a lot of money at the time, anyway. The room service guy, he comes in. And he sees this scene that I just described to you, and he says, George Best.
Greatest footballer of all time.
Exactly, the greatest footballer of all time. I have to ask you, where did it all go wrong?
Where did it all go wrong?
Where did it all go wrong?
Where did it all go wrong,
yeah, George but Best? I think that the room service guy, you know, I think he makes a very good point. Huh?